This video was sponsored by Netmarble. Hey family, what's going on? And welcome to Iron Throne. My name is Klaus, and today we're going to be beginning the beginner's guide to Iron Throne. Now, this game is beautiful, first of all. I love the way it looks, and I love the story, but you just got to admire the beauty. I mean, the forest, the little village, the giant castle, and of course, the dragon. Who doesn't love dragons, right? So this game is very, very similar to Clash of Clans, the game that my channel is known for. And it is, the basics is you have a castle, as you can see. I was going to do this for you. Let me just show you what the idea was. I was going to start the video here. I was going to make it very simple. It's like, hey, look at the forest. And, oh, look, there's a little wall. And we're gonna walk through this quarry and look, there's like farms and stuff on either side, and there's some soldiers and there's a wall, and then there's an amazing dude on a horse in the doorway, and then you back up and bam, there is the castle. This is your castle, and essentially what you're doing is your mortal enemy in the game has come back and he is trying to kill the world or destroy the world or destroy you or whatever. So your job is to develop your castle, get stronger, and go destroy him. Now, that's not going to happen at the beginning because obviously he's very powerful, so you have to spend some time developing your castle. Now, I know that this is an extremely, there's a lot of stuff to look at on the screen. And so we're going to go through this little by little. This is, again, the beginner's guide. Oh, and I love this idle screen, by the way. If you don't click anything for like a minute, this thing starts circling around your castle. I think it's beautiful. The game is very well put together. Shout out to Netmarble and 4plat for making this game beautiful. But anyway, so let's talk about, first of all, the resources. Obviously, the game's all about the loot, right? You've got to get that loot. You've got to build. You've got to develop. And you've got to have the resources required. So if I actually scroll up and put the numbers inside the water so you can see at the very, very top, you can see I've got 3.8 million food. I've got a lot of food. I don't need more food. I'm good on the food side of things. But we got a lot of wood as well. Stone is coming up next, just under 1,993,000, just over 1 million iron, and then finally we have silver coins. Those are the five major resources that you need to get stuff done in the game. Now, right next to that, the 11,415 gold coins is the currency that allows you to get stuff done a little bit quicker in the game. Oh, that idle screen. I've got to click the screen more often. Anyway, so the gold coins are a way to be able to get maybe speed ups or buffs to your troops or whatever, because yes, you've got troops, you've got to go fight on occasion. And so there's a way to actually purchase the gold for money, and that's definitely an option for you if you want to be able to advance quicker in the game. Now, if you look to the left of the resources, you can see the guy with the crown, the white beard, and the epic hair, and the 14 at the top left-hand side. That is my profile picture. I'm level 14 currently. Klaus Gaming is my tag and my name, basically, and it gives statistics on the game. I'm not very advanced. I just started the game, but I'm really enjoying it so far. Next to that, at the just below that, you can see the hammer with the 23-minute countdown. So you can only build one building or upgrade one building at a time. So if I actually select that, it shows me that I'm upgrading this iron mine. And that's good. I need to upgrade that iron mine. And I'll explain why here in just a moment. But before we get to that, look just below that hammer on the left-hand side, that green thing that says free. That means that one of my upgrades can be finished early, which is great. So this is going to bring us to the Academy. All right, the Academy, similar to the laboratory in Clash of Clans, the game I'm, you know, known for, my channel's known for, is kind of the backbone of the intellect of your city, of your castle, of your land here. And it allows you to be able to become more efficient or have better troops or better anything. It's a fantastic building and definitely need to keep things researching. As you can see on the right-hand side, if you keep things researching, then you are going to advance quicker in the game. So I was actually sticking with city because I wanted to focus on troop training capacity. I want to be able to train up troops quickly and efficiently. So I'm going to go ahead and start this research. It's going to take 4 hours and 32 minutes to do. That's fine. I'm willing to wait on that. Now, remember whenever I said, and I'll click it again, that the iron mine is upgrading and that's a good thing. Well, if you look at the bottom left-hand side of the screen, there is a little yellow arrow that says next. That's like your tutorial quest line. So the tutorial of the game is very good. It explains all the stuff in great detail. If you decide to download it, besides you probably should, there's a link down below in the description for you if you would like to download the game Iron Throne and play it. I'm having a good time. I love how complicated the game is. That's always what keeps my attention. But the tutorial leads you through what you should upgrade and why. And so right now it's saying you need to upgrade your iron mine. As soon as it's done, it'll turn green. It'll say congratulations and it'll give you a ton of rewards. By the way, this game is fantastic at rewarding you for everything that you do. It's great. Directly below that, there's like the global chat. You can go chat with people if you want, or if you join an alliance. Yes, guys, there are alliances in this game. If you decide to join an alliance or start one of your own, then you can chat with them. And then below that, you have the quests. Bottom left-hand corner. I've got a lot of quests that are available to me. Starting at the top is the challenges. I kind of already mentioned that. That's kind of like the tutorial. What you should upgrade next. It kind of gives you a good idea of, you know, how you should organize and develop your city. So I don't need to click and gather anything from these rewards. But right now, the current recommended challenge is upgrading that iron mine, and that is what I'm doing. Next, we have the daily quests, and these daily quests are basically just ways to reward you for paying attention. I'm just gonna claim it. It gave me a ton of food and wood and stone and experience and things, and then I'm gonna start the next one, and it's just a 4-minute countdown. What it does, and you know, that one's 4 minutes, the one below that's 3 minutes, the one below that's 16 minutes. It's just a way to reward you for paying attention and doing the daily quest, essentially. And then below that, we have alliance quests, and if I was in an alliance, it would give me quests for things that I could do, donating resources to people or donating troops to people or whatever it is. And then below that is the VIP daily quest, and it gives you things that you need to do. Like right now, I need to gather resources. That's my next thing I need to do. To finish this VIP daily quest, and you can gather resources in the multiplayer map. I'll show you that here in just a moment. And then below that, we have the Chronicles, and the Chronicles are, again, just a bunch of different little quests. There's like, see, it feels like 100 different quests that you can be doing at any time in the game. It keeps you very entertained. So I'm going to claim that one. I don't even know what I did for it, but it gave me 50,000 hero XP. That's great. And then I'll do it again, because it let me. 100,000 hero XP and 1,600 gold. Fantastic. I've got a ton of gold. That's awesome. So yeah, so that's all the quests, and that by itself will keep you very, very busy. Below that is items, and we're not going to get into items in this video. I'm going to be doing two more videos after this explaining things in more detail, but items and heroes, which we'll collect just so I can show you, they go very well together. So the heroes are the generals of your army, or maybe they're the scholars, or maybe they're the treasurers. They're the ones that are really leading your city, leading your armies to success. So right now I have Maria, who is kind of like the beginner hero. She's a beast. She's very powerful, and I've got her appointed as basically my general for going out and fighting. And then I've also got Carl, who's my guard captain. He was the one sitting on the horse at the beginning of the video, by the way. He's epic. Look at that. Look at his sword. It's glowing. Dude's a monster. And then lastly, we have Harold, and Harold is a beast as well. Each hero has very specific strengths and weaknesses. So this guy is good for construction speed. So he's basically in charge of the city. He's kind of like the manager of the city. So heroes are a very big and important part of the game, something we will definitely cover in more detail in a later video. Again, alliance at the very bottom, talking about if you're an alliance, you can chat with them or do quests or whatever. We'll have to get into more detail on that later as well. And then mail. On occasion, you will receive mail if the game needs to update. They might send you a reward or something. And then at the bottom right-hand side gives you all kinds of other stuff you can click through and read through if you want to. Changing settings, things like that. And then working your way up, guys, as you can see, that circle that says world, bottom right-hand corner, world will send you to the multiplayer map. We're going to click that in just a moment. But if you see that treasure box on the left-hand side, that is what's up, guys. That treasure box is actually your boats that are running around and getting stuff for you. Again, just another way to reward you for looking at, for playing the game. And then I don't know what that thing is that's in the water, but if you click it, it gives you silver. So I don't know, it's like fish that delivers money. I'm fine with that. That's cool. And then we have the battlefield button, and the battlefield button, it's the storyline. You get to go in and you get to fight the bad guy, who that there he is, the Sauron or Sauron looking guy or whatever his name was from Lord of the Rings. But yeah, that is kind of like the main storyline. And then at the top, it's telling you again about sales. You can buy this gold currency and really advance in the game quickly if you so choose to. Now that is everything on the UI, which is kind of like the things you can click on the map that is in a building. Now we have the building, and I'll just quickly try to show you guys and tell you guys what these all are, but they all have their own specific functions. And if you do end up playing the game, which I highly recommend you do, again, the download link is in the description below. then you'll be able to read on these yourself. But the main building, and the one that deserves the most attention, is the Citadel. Essentially the Town Hall, if you're a Clash of Clans player. And the Citadel really controls everything. It really allows, it unlocks buildings, it unlocks special buildings that are on the map that only unlock at certain levels. So if I back out, actually, and then come over here and look, you can see this building here at the very top. It says Citadel level 13 is required for the prison. I'm only Citadel 12, so I don't have access to the prison just yet. Also, if you look, there's that dragon from the intro screen, by the way. Dude's beautiful, but I have to be Citadel level 15 to access the altar. So yeah, the Citadel is a very, very important building, and the game, again, designed well to allow you to slowly enter the game and learn how the game works, so it doesn't give you every building at once. It allows you to be able to slowly work your way through and become acquainted with the game, with how the game works. But also, Citadel, if I click it again, has a point at the bottom in the middle. If I click that, there is where you appoint your heroes for certain jobs. Guard Captain, obviously he's going to be a beefy guy. Architect, Treasurer, Scholar, they all have their benefits, and they all will help you to advance better in the game. And then next, guys, we have just a bunch of buildings. The Embassy, which is a very important thing for if you have an alliance. Hall of War, same thing. It's a gathering place for members of the Alliance to go out and fight somebody. So that's obviously an important thing. And then this glowing thing here, the Dimensional Gate, sends you to more or less the multiplayer map where you get to go do battles. And don't worry, guys, we're going to be doing some battles in the next video. It's going to be a lot of fun. I want to show you guys how combat works. We don't have time for that right now. But what we do have time for, again, we've already talked about the Academy. Very, very important building. Maybe the most important building in the game. Next, we have the altar, and the temple is going to give you free stuff, basically. If you click the wish button, you get to make a wish and get free stuff. At the very bottom, it's a 5-minute speed up, so you can kind of speed up through these upgrades. Or if you need a certain resource, this thing will give it to you for free, and you get 7 free wishes. Apparently every day, so that is very, very generous of the game. And then next we have this building. This is the command center, another very, very important building, because it will allow you and determines the size of the amount of troops that you can send out to fight. You need to upgrade that baby, make sure it is well developed. And then behind there, the what looks like maybe a lighthouse or something, that's actually the watchtower. It will alert you if somebody's attacking you. And that perfectly segues into what I was saying earlier, is the multiplayer map. So let me back up, we'll come back to the castle, and I want to show you guys the multiplayer map. So if you hit the world button at the bottom right hand side, it will bring you to the multiplayer map. So yes, this is where our castle actually is. Yes, I know it looks like we're on the water, but it's an illusion. We're not really, we're out in the middle of this grass field here. If you look, we see, yep, there is another person directly to my southeast, and they're level 16. You can see that by the 16 next to their name. So yeah, there is a very, very open world. There is a level 25 there, level 18 there, and as you can see, we have a blue shield around us, which means we cannot be attacked, but there will come a time when you can just attack somebody. Of course, you want to be careful, because if they're in an alliance, you might start a war and everybody's just going to come destroy you. So you got to be careful. Also, one other thing is you have resources that you can actually gather that are sitting around. It might not be inside of your castle, but it's next to, and you could send troops and workers to go gather those resources. So I could actually gather some silver out of this silver mine if I really wanted to. So there's the multiplayer map, guys. Oh, also look at this thing, Kelpie, level 10. So you can actually go fight these creatures that are on the bottom up, these monsters, and it'll give you tons of rewards for that as well. So there's a lot goes into this game. That's why I really wanted to give a very thorough video just explaining everything that can be done in the game, and they get more detail later on. So let's hop back into our castle, guys, and talk about the final buildings that are left that we haven't discussed yet. We have the forge, which gets us into items, into armor and weapons and stuff, which is very, very important for the heroes. We'll be definitely getting into that more in more detail in the hero video. And then we've got the inn, which I think is one of the most fun things that you can do. And one of the most best things you can do is the random card thing. Basically, you get these ancient coins. You get them randomly for rewards. And you can use those ancient coins to flip these cards and get free loot. It's great. I've already done 5, but let's do another one. I can use some of these ancient coins. Let's use 9 because I think I had 1 already. So now I've got 10. So now we can flip a card. So let's just flip the top card. 24-hour speed-up. Three 24-hour speed-ups. So if I've got a building that's going to take 3 days to finish, I can finish it immediately with that. And it didn't really cost me anything. That is awesome. That was definitely the best one I've found so far, by the way. So, yeah, the inn is cool. What else can the inn do? I don't even know. Quests. Oh, yeah. The quest. This is another way to get to that quest button that's at the bottom left-hand side of your screen. It's the exact same thing. I would recommend sticking to the quest because they reward you very, very nicely. And I believe that's all for the inn. Besides, obviously, you can upgrade it for more benefit. And then this is the rally point. This is where your troops hang out. And you have to upgrade all these things. You have the archery range at the top, training grounds to its left, stable at the bottom, and siege workshops to its left. You upgrade all those to give yourself access to different troops and stronger troops. And then the rally point, obviously, is where all the troops gather before they go fight. And right now you can see my troop count at the top left-hand side, 930 out of 930. So that's a lot of troops that we can carry, but not near as many as we need. We need to keep upgrading this stuff. And I believe that really does it for the random buildings. The marketplace is important for your alliance as well because you can send resources to your people. And then the storehouse, I think this is, yeah, the warehouse holds your stuff basically. If somebody comes and attacks you, that's where your loot is going to be. And it's a good idea to have that strengthened up because it can hold more and it'll take more for people to take it out. And then we've already talked about the boats. Free loot for everyone. So that pretty much covers it for the castle. And then you can see there's a lot of fields. We can actually have resources being accumulated over time. If I go in and I select, I don't know what I want to select. Let's select this, forest right here. All right, so it's a lumberyard. And if I upgrade it, it goes from developing a 200 production per hour to 400 production per hour. And it actually increases the maximum capacity as well. So if you can't log in a lot, then it'll continue accumulating and not get full as long as this is upgraded high to a high level. So definitely want to be upgrading those things. And there's a lot of plots for different buildings that we can build. And there's a lot of options. I mean, there's 7, I think, different options. And you can build 10 of each of those. So that means there's 70 options. And I've already counted, there are 33 plots that we can use up. So you can't build all the buildings. So I haven't built them yet because I don't know what I'm going to need yet. Like I said, I pretty much just started playing the game and it's been fun. So let's click that thing there, the Inferno Edge. High Wizard Liveratus did not agree with Infidus's ideals. Infidus is the bad guy. The High Wizard attempted to use relics to prevent Infidus from having a chance to destroy the world. So you can sit there and you can read. That's a little bit of a backstory on exactly what the game is all about. And then lastly, and this is really cool, is the Dimensional Void. The Dimensional Void allows you to go out and fight other people. It's just a fun thing to do. I think there's rewards. I mean, you can check the rewards here. 7-day training speed. Oh my goodness. Yeah, it would be kind of awesome to win. So it's a battle royale. 20 players, you and 19 others, go in on this island, very battle royale-esque, and you go and you fight and you try to win. Supposedly, based on the battle preparation thing there, all of the information, everybody's even basically. And it's all about your wit, it's all about your strategy, and about how good of a player you are. So there's a lot. I mean, I know guys, I probably skipped some stuff, but I tried to cover everything and be as simple yet detailed as I could to explain what is going on in this game. But essentially, you're trying to build it up, you're trying to become a stronger lord, have a better castle, and go destroy the bad guys. Who doesn't want to do that? And plus, again, the loot is everywhere, and you can do a ton of stuff. Ooh, and we can finish off that iron mine. Sweet. So the iron mine is done, and as you see, that thing at the bottom left-hand side that went from a yellow arrow is now a green arrow. So I'm going to click that, and boom! Look at all that. Look at all that stuff we were given. That is awesome. Now it wants us to upgrade a forge to level 12. So let's just upgrade that. I've got to wait 48 minutes. I could, if I wanted to, hit that speed up button and use one of my speed ups. I might not. I haven't decided. Hard to think through whether I want to while I'm filming. So that's about it, guys. That's going to do it for our little beginner's guide to Iron Throne. I hope you enjoyed it. Please let me know in the comments if you did. Like this video if you liked it. If you feel like you learned something. Oh, the silverfish. Hold on. Yes. Yeah, more silver. Gotta love that free silver. And the fish. The fish just finds silver in the bottom of the ocean. It's amazing. But yeah, guys, like the video if you liked it. Hit that subscribe button if you have not done so already for daily gaming videos. And download the game. Thank you so much for watching, and thank you again to Net Marble for getting me in contact with this game. Guys, I love you, and I will see you all again next time.